Good morning. Welcome to your graduation ceremony. Congratulations on all your achievements. Today is about you, so relax, take it all in, and enjoy the experience. You'll receive your testament from staff, who will be located in the Eastern Hall as you make your way to the stage. You'll then carry your testament with you as you cross the stage and stand on a cross that is 1.5 metres distance from the chancellor or presider. If you're wearing a mask, you may wish to remove this before you cross the stage as your photo will be taken. We recommend either removing your mask and leaving it at your seat, or removing it just before you step on a stage and place it in your pocket or out of sight. We now have a couple of videos to play for you to demonstrate what will happen during your ceremony. Here's the first part.
Welcome to your graduation ceremony and congratulations on your achievements. Today is about you, so relax, take it all in, and most of all, enjoy it. Before we begin, please remember to either turn off your mobile phone or switch it to silent. Keep any belongings like bags or umbrellas under your seat and leave them there when it's time to cross the stage. Speaking of seats, make sure you're sitting in yours. Seats will be labelled with a program containing your seat number and name. The order you're sitting in is the order which you'll be presented on stage, so stay in your allocated seat and leave any empty seats unfilled as people may arrive late. When it's time to make your way to the stage, look to staff in black polo tops. They'll prompt you to stand row by row and let you know where to walk. Staff may also be wearing white polo shirts or a graduation gown, so make sure you follow their direction at all times. Before you cross the stage, there'll be three checkpoints: at the middle doors, just before the stage, and on stage. At each point, say your name clearly but quietly to staff, who'll check you're in the correct order. If you're sitting on stage, staff will let you know before the ceremony what you need to do when collecting your testament. When you're in position on stage, step up to the black line. When your full name's announced, walk along the carpet to the chancellor or presider.
When you reach the staff member standing on stage, your name will then be checked. You'll be then asked to stand on the black line. I'll demonstrate this for you shortly. When your name is announced, you're required to walk across the stage and stand next to the chancellor. Please hold your testament on your right side facing forward, so it is positioned between yourself and the chancellor. Ensure that you're facing forward as the photographer will take your photo. We will now play the remainder of the video to explain what you need to do after your photo has been taken.
Walk through the side door to leave the stage and walk down the corridor. Take care, as the wooden floor is well polished and can be slippery in high heels. At the middle doors, turn left to re-enter the hall and use the middle aisle to return to your seat. There, you'll remain seated until the end of the ceremony. If you have any questions, please ask our friendly staff. And once again, congratulations and have a wonderful day.
After you leave the stage, you're presented with an alumni bag from the staff member from the alumni team. We recommend that you do not use this bag to carry your testament. It's not quite big enough and could cause the edges of your testament to be damaged. There is a fee involved if you need to order a replacement testament. Please be aware that the ceremony is live streamed and you'll be able to watch it later on the university website official YouTube page. Your mortarboard should sit flat on your head with a tassel on the left side towards the front. Please make sure that you adjust the Velcro strap on the back of your mortarboard to ensure that it fits your head. If you're wearing stilettos, please be very careful walking along the walls of the hall. There are grates on the floor and your heels can become stuck in them. Staff will help you check your academic dress in the corridor before you get to the stage. Please tell staff if you do not wish for them to adjust. At the end of the ceremony, you'll be prompted to walk two by two as part of the academic reception to exit Bonython Hall. If you need to use the toilet, please do so after this briefing. If you move from your seat once the ceremony starts, you may miss out on being presented. Once you're outside, enjoy the day with your family and friends. And once again, congratulations on all your achievements. Thank you.
Graduates, congratulations.
You did it.
Well done and congratulations.
You now join a very, very special list of elite people from around the globe.
Alongside astronauts,
prime ministers,
and everything in between.
It's now your time.
You've joined a global community
of achievers, believers,
innovators, and creators.
A community of history makers.
We know that these are big shoes to fill.
But we also know that you've got this.
It's a great thing to reach the end point and to celebrate your graduation today.
Well done, and congratulations.
And not just to you, but to your mum, your dad,
your grandma, your grandpa,
aunts, uncles, your dog, cat,
and even your pet iguana.
They've all supported you to achieve your best.
Be proud of what you've done.
We certainly are.
So for you guys now,
take a breath,
drink it in, watch some Netflix.
Go on, you earn it.
And know that the world is ready for you.
And you're ready for the world.
In a year of making history and living it,
we can't wait to see what history you'll make
as graduates of the University of Adelaide. Good morning, and welcome to the University of Adelaide graduation ceremony. This morning's ceremony is for the graduates from the Faculty of Health and Medical Sciences. The ceremony will commence very shortly. The university has a contract photographer to provide photography services during the ceremony. If you wish to take photos, I would ask that you do so discreetly from your seat, and please do not use flash. To maintain the ceremony's sense of occasion, please switch off your mobile phones. In a case of an emergency, please follow the direction of staff members. The emergency assembly point is the Goodman Crescent Lawns to the western side of Bonython Hall, and the evacuation plan can be found on page 9 of your program. For safety reasons, guests are not to enter the galleries upstairs, and please do not sit in the steps in the balcony area. Thank you and enjoy the ceremony. The academic procession is about to enter the hall. We'll be singing the national anthem. The words are on page 8 of your program. Please now stand if you're comfortably able to do so for the academic procession and remain standing for the national anthem.
Good morning, everyone. I, Mr. Kenneth Williams, Deputy Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, declare open this congregation convened for the purpose of presenting degrees. Distinguished guests, parents, relatives, friends, and especially the graduates, welcome to the University of Adelaide graduation ceremony. We acknowledge the Kaurna people, past and present, the original custodians of the Adelaide Plains, and thus of the land on which the University of Adelaide campuses are built. We acknowledge the Kaurna people's ongoing spiritual connection with this land. Graduates, your graduation is an event in which you and your family and friends can take great pride. It is also a source of great pride and satisfaction for the University of Adelaide. Graduation Day is an opportunity for you to reflect upon both the past and on the future. This day may well signal a significant change in the direction of your life, but whatever direction your life may take from here, the knowledge that you have acquired and the skills that you have acquired and have learned and developed here should stand you in good stead. Not only in your working life and professional life, but we hope in your personal life. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce our graduate orator, Mr. Simon Schrapple, AM. Simon has enjoyed over 35 years working in the social and community services field in Australia and abroad in a range of practices, which includes both policy, planning and management roles. This has involved positions in local government, state government and non-government organisations. He is currently the Chief Executive of Uniting Communities, a South Australian-based community service agency committed to social justice and inclusion. Simon has committed to a strong focus on placemaking and building inclusive, connected communities throughout his career. He has undertaken a number of leadership positions in sector peak bodies, advocacy groups, and advisory boards. Simon was president of ACOS from 2009 to 2013, having served as chair of SACOS from 2002 to 2009. He's a past chair of the Child and Family Welfare Association of Australia and Families Australia and current chair of Food Bank SA. Simon served as a member of the National Compact Advisory Group, and amongst other positions, he has been member of the Prime Minister's National Panel on Economic Reform, the Premier's Council on Suicide Prevention, together with a host of other government-appointed boards. Simon is also currently the National Co-Chair of Anti-Poverty Week. Simon was awarded the membership of the Order of Australia in 2017 for his services to children and family services as part of the community sector. We are privileged to hear him speak today. Please welcome Mr. Simon Schrapple, AM. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that introduction and welcome everyone today. Can I also start by acknowledging that we are all meeting on Kaurna land, and I'd like to pay my respects to elders past, present and emerging. Can I acknowledge just a few special guests before talking to you a little bit about a personal experience, which I hope some of you might find of some value. Can I acknowledge Mr. Ken Williams, the Deputy Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, the Deputy Vice-Chancellor, External Engagement of the University of Adelaide, Professor Tracy Merlin, the Interim Head of the School of Public Health, Professor Elaine Fox, Head of School of Psychology, the faculty of the University of Adelaide who are present today, but most importantly to you, our graduates, and also to the family and friends that are joining you here today. I know the focus, quite rightly, is all about you, but I hope that we'll be able to also acknowledge the fundamental role that those around you have provided over the last number of years and through your study to support you to get you to where you are today. I suspect that your immediate focus is about getting onto this stage safely, making sure you don't trip up the stairs, that you don't blink when the photo's being taken, and then at the end of it all to be able to disrobe and to go and celebrate in your own particular way with your family and your friends that have joined you here today. I suspect the way that you're feeling is a very personal thing, and it's as varied as there are graduates in the room today. Some of you, you'll be reflecting on the last number of years that have got to you to where you are today. For others of you, it might have been, I had to get up a bit earlier this morning and it's cold and, you know, I'm managed to get robed up and I'm looking forward to the rest of the day. I reflect a bit back, it was many years ago that I graduated with my first degree. And I think it would be fair to say when I look back at it, and I didn't actually attend a ceremony like this. I was living in Darwin at the time. It was a few months after finishing my course, and I didn't make it back to Adelaide for my graduation. And I regret that now, I really do. But I suspect at that time, I was just turned 21, and I think I was a little indifferent about the importance and the value of what you're going through today. Maybe I'd taken a little bit for granted. So what I wanted to share with you is not so much my experience of graduation, because I didn't really come and have this experience that you're having today, but something that happened a little while after I graduated. And it reminded me of an old adage or maxim that goes something along the lines of, you don't quite appreciate the value of what you've got until you don't have it. And so here's a little story I wanted to share with you and a little bit of the learnings I got from that. So after graduating, I went to Darwin and worked in the juvenile justice field for about 12 months. Juvenile justice work in Darwin in the Northern Territory then was probably much as it is today, alas. And then I headed, like many others at the time, over to the UK, feeling that my best experience in my early years of my career would be gained from going and working overseas. So I lobbed up in London, found it fairly easy, fortunately at the time, to get a job as a social worker in a local government authority, only to be confronted by this little challenge. My degree wasn't accepted. Now, before you start panicking that Australian degrees aren't worth anything in the UK, I can assure you they are, and yours particularly so, I suspect. But my experience was not about the quality of my degree, because the degree absolutely was accepted. It was me that wasn't accepted. So I was confronted with a situation. I'd graduated just before I turned 21, and I think this was well before age discrimination had really, certainly the authorities in the UK had understood what age discrimination was. And they said to me, yes, we accept your qualification, Mr. Schrapple, and you can work as an unqualified worker because we don't accept you because you qualified too young. Just reflect on that for a moment. I'd qualified too young. They said, we don't believe that anybody could qualify at that age and fully appreciate the value of the education they received. So they kindly offered me an opportunity to do another four-year degree, which I said, I don't think so. Thank you for the opportunity, but you know, I think I've just done 4 years and I wanted to get out and do some work, and I reckon I'm raring to go. I'd done a bit of work in some pretty tough circumstances in Australia before I'd gone over there. So what I did, and this has really set me, I think, on a career that has very much focused on issues of social justice. Now, I'm not suggesting what I was confronted with was one of the great injustices of the world. It was far from it. You know, I had a job, I was being paid at a different level. I certainly didn't think it was very fair. I felt quite indignant about it. But what I did was establish at the time an association, because I started to contact others who were having similar experiences for different reasons, but their qualifications weren't being accepted. And you know, there's a whole industry around the world of helping people to ensure that their qualifications are accepted wherever they go and are transferable. And I established at the time, at the ripe old age of 21, the Association of Social Workers Trained Abroad. I don't quite know what the acronym sounded like, but that's what it was called. And gathered together a number of others who are facing similar experiences of not having their qualification recognised. I think within about 3 months, the authorities in the UK had realised the folly of their decision to not accept me on that basis, and that it was probably very challengeable even in those days in the courts if I'd wanted to take it that far. But the point I wanted to make was not so much about, well, there's two points really. One is about valuing what you are getting today, and certainly is to never undervalue it, because at that point I felt pretty aggrieved that, you know, something I'd worked hard for was not going to be recognised. But what it did set me on was a path of, you know, understanding and appreciating the power of collective engagement, really, of being able to join with others and to look at injustices wherever they might be and to fight them. And in a sense, it's been a very important part of my career, and you've got a bit of a flavour of that in the little bio that was read out earlier. I've spent much of my career working with organisations, leading organisations, to challenge injustices, whether they be about people getting a fair and decent income, adequate housing, whatever it may be. And for much of my career, I have to say that, you know, some of those challenges and some of that advocacy effort has been tough going. I reflected back last night. I don't know how many people sat up and listened to the budget last night. It's probably not, you know, mandatory viewing and listening for most of us, but we all sort of listened in to see how people are going to be affected by it. And I reflected back on 12 years ago, at a point where I was the president of the Australian Council of Social Service, where we started a whole campaign to lift the rate. It wasn't called Job Seeker in those days, but the unemployment benefit and other associated benefits, including student benefits. And here we are, 12 years later, 12 budgets later, and I don't want to be political today, it's not the place to do it, but a measly $40 a fortnight we got passed on in Job Seeker and other allowances really didn't cut it, did it? And so that fight continues. There's many others that I've been involved in will continue as well. So the point I want to leave you with is this, that I guess through that early experience, I learnt two things, the value of the education I received, but also the importance of finding your place to make a difference in the world. And so my challenge to you is, what are you going to transform? How are you going to use your education to transform the world and change the world around you? For some of you, I suspect it'll be at a very personal and individual level. You'll help people that are struggling with trauma, with other issues in their lives, to make more sense of that, to be able to manage and cope much better. You may be helping families to reconnect, or at least understand how relationships work. For some of you, you'll work in an organisational context to make organisations more compassionate, maybe sometimes just more efficient and better at what they're doing. And for others of you, you may take that advocacy path, you may take that social justice path. And if you're in the public health arena, golly gosh, what a better time to be coming out and working in public health, as at the end, if I can say it's the end of a pandemic, and you'll make an enormous difference in that place. So my challenge to you is to think through today about how you will use what you have worked so hard to get to help make your point of difference in the world around us. How will you help to transform the world that we live in? And so as you go from here to celebrate with your friends and your family, I'd just like you to give that moment of thought about, A, the value of what you're actually getting in your parchment today. Whether you put that parchment in a frame or whether you put it in a drawer, it's what you carry with you. It's what you've fought hard to get, what you've worked hard to get. And I ask you that you use it for good in the way that you best can. Thank you very much.
On behalf of the graduates and their families attending today's ceremony, I would like to thank Mr. Simon Schrapple for his stimulating and inspiring address. We are honoured that you have taken the time to join us on this special day to share with us your thoughts and experiences. Your words of encouragement and advice are greatly appreciated. They remind us that education places upon each of us an enduring responsibility to make the best possible use of our talents and to contribute to the betterment of society in whatever way we can. Please join me in once again thanking Mr. Simon Schrapple.
Deputy Chancellor, I, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice Chancellor External Engagement of the University of Adelaide, certulate to you and the whole university that the graduates who will be presented to you have all fulfilled the conditions prescribed for admission to the award for which they are so presented.
I, Mr. Kenneth Williams, Deputy Chancellor of the University of Adelaide, by virtue of the power committed to me by the university, confirm that each graduate is admitted to the rank and privileges of a holder of the award in the University of Adelaide for which they are so presented. I call on the interim head of the School of Public Health, Professor Tracy Merlin, to present the graduates.
Deputy Chancellor, I, Interim Head of the School of Public Health, Professor Tracy Merlin, present to you graduates from the School of Public Health. To the graduate certificate in Biostatistics, not just yet. We'll just wait a moment. Okay, to the Graduate Certificate in Biostatistics, Zara Asani. And also receiving the degree of the Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, Stephanie Maria Layden. To the Graduate Diploma in Counselling and Psychotherapy, Samantha Kelly Reynolds. And Kalara Zolpa. To the degree of Master of Public Health, Chelsea Grace Alexander. Dominic Junfong Chong. Courtney Georgia Hammond. Danae Martin Henderson. Jingchen Huyan. Akiko Imai. Simran Julka. Emily Kovachev. Navya Sai Kudapa. Yichao Lee. Isaiah Luke. Nikita Motlani. Michael Peter Skin. To keep on. Juan Sun. Nguyen Khai Duyen Vo. Suzanne Elizabeth Whitehead. Michelle Suzanne Wong. To the degree of Master of Biostatistics, Jana Maria Bednarz. And Lingwen Davies. To the degree of Master of Counselling and Psychotherapy, Jake Alex Byron. Olivia Grace Carletti. Jessica Jade Doherty. Alexandra, excuse me, Alexandra Francis Drew. Jade Marie Forgan. Amy Ellen Heffernan. Thomas Henry Johnson. Rachel Ann McCall. Daniela Meisner. Tandika Ndolovu. Elizabeth Wright Rhiannon Payne. Emma Kate Peterson. Mariah Radamisis. Julia Rossini. Bina Shaparam. And Caitlin Rochelle Wilson. To the degree of Master of Clinical Science, for a thesis entitled Use of Electrocardiogram Monitoring in Adult Patients Taking High-Risk QT Interval Prolonging Drugs in Clinical Practice, a Systematic Review, Mariana Putnikovic. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Impact of Non-Technical Skills on Performance and Effectiveness of a Rapid Response System, Dr. Richard Chalwin. For a thesis entitled Investigating an Alternative Regulatory and Reimbursement Framework for Antimicrobials in Australia, Dr. Nadine Hillock. Nadine's my student. For a thesis entitled Closing the Implementation Gap in Pre-Deployment Medical AI Study Design, Dr. Lauren Oakden Rayner. For a thesis entitled The Development and Testing of Australian Pre-Hospital Care Quality Indicators, Dr. Robin Papp. and for a thesis entitled Validating a Population Measure of Early Childhood Development in Low and Middle Income Countries, the Early Human Capability Index, Dr. Ilana Sinkovic. Deputy Chancellor, this concludes the graduates from the School of Public Health.
Deputy Chancellor, I, Head of the School of Psychology, Professor Elaine Fox, present to you graduates from the School of Psychology. To the degree of Bachelor of Psychological Science, Shuyala Adeyamiabat. Aisha Mon Ahmed. Selina Marie Alusi. Elizabeth Rose Anderson Gibbs. Jordan Christopher Anthony. James Carl Toshiki Asakura Ward. Rachel Kayan Au Young. Callista Marie Bachik. Gabrielle Rose Barry. Amelia Rose Bennett. Anisu Bipete. Jasmine Singh Barra. Samantha Blackmore. Georgia Borg. Isabella Brand. Kobe Robert Browning. Jack Ethan Castine Price. Billy Patrice Catalano. Nokian Chessy Chan. Kerry Galen Chowis. Monty Sean Clark. Alexander Cole. Keziah Dawn Crawford. Jade Amber Crombie. Benjamin Cena. Nicole Deacon. Ivana Demich. Bronte Lee Edgecombe. Georgina Edwards. Liam Carlos Edwards. Riley Cooper Egan. Gemma L. Mohammed. Fami Farhan. Grace Elizabeth Fawcett. Cassidy Forlong. Olivia Louise Frew. Benjamin Adam Fry. Taylor Chet Gatto. Rose Isabella Goodwin. Belinda Gull. Mia Bella Jane Habel. Portia Herverton. Alicia J. Hua. Heywa Tracy Ip. Nicole Kate Ivanoff. Courtney Elizabeth James. Anna Jovanovic. Corey Bradley Kennedy. Lauren Jade Kennett. Yang Kwa. Olivia Lang. Brandon Lee. Junwen Lee. Leona Lovell. India Constance Lumbers. Nora Markov. Dante Asaya Mazzio. Leo McKenzie. Jordan Linda McNamara. Anastasia Olympia Michalakis. Lauren Amy Morgan. Abigail Natalia Norona. Louisa Claire O'Callaghan Ray. Elizabeth Diane Ordinsky. Maisie Renata Packer. Alicia Rose Penacune. Ella Catherine Peterson. Luca Possibon. Luke Price. Jade Tellier Pryor. Alina Rafiq. Raquel Richards. Matthew Stephen Rodel. Aviana Rosalyn. Anthea Jacqueline Angela Robery. Christian Sanato. Andrea Samtani. Indiana Nicole Brogio. Daniel Philip Scalzi. Samuel Schaff. Todd Lewis Sibben. Jack Michael Soden. Joanne Simone Tu. Alexandra Ray Tubb. Adam Angelo Filano. Carla Virdis. Suna Fora. Keisha Danielle Wall. Janika Wanakusa Iria. Sarah Waters. Laura Ann Wennan. Catherine White. Sophie Chessy Woods. Suman Yarsabu. And Wenzun Zhu. To the honours degree of Bachelor of Psychology Advanced, Fatima Abidkadir. Hannah Louise Alexandru. Ruby Bishop Gully. Monmaya Chamlagai. Amelia Jane Delich. Philip Dobek. Anna Mary Hifferty. Alexandra Karadzic. Sumaya Keza Abdinur. Bethany Ellen Kimber. Annabelle Rose Law. Ka Yi Lu. Rachel Min. Mitchell Martin Dickmanis. Charlotte Gemina Rayner. Benjamin Paul Simmons. Courtney Allura Spitz. Harry Ross Spurier. And Ellie Kendall Turner. To the honours degree of Bachelor of Psychological Science, Karina Florence Brand. Meg Victoria Bruce. Rosanna Patricia Burt. Dora Mary Davis. Eileen Argenbush. Rebecca Louise Etienne. Alexis Fox Hughes. Rachel Adele Fratini. Jessica Lauren Frund. Dave Singh Chende. Estelle Bridie Green. Hannah Nicole Hamilton. Isabel Therese Harris. Ruby Claire O'Brien Head. Solale Chiranlu. Samuel James Koutsouridis. Wei Sin La. Joe James Mandrell. Brianna Eve Monaghan. Brooke Susan Norris. Mitchell James Osborne. Kai Jaden Palmer. Alexandra Jade Culp Penford. Isabel Kate Phyllis. Adele Amanda Quazzoli. Sarah Louise Rafestine. Georgia Ann Reeves. Alexandra Paul Sakura Prispilia. Michaela Ann Sloan. Stephanie Jasmine Lee Smith. Rachel Nicole Stewart. Angus Oliver Stillwell. Nicole Lee Aung Tan. Joanne Waugh. Caitlin Nicole Wyatt. And Vanessa Catherine Young. To the Graduate Certificate in Psychology, Neo Kongya Chai Tai. To the Graduate Diploma in Psychology Advanced, Danielle Melissa Brown. Christy Downey. Corey Darrell Kenny Holland. Aldina Cornetta. Naomi Lehman. Chelsea Ella Murray. Dominique Carmel Saracino. And Anna Fiona Siebert. To the Graduate Diploma in Psychology, Gabrielle Elizabeth Candlish. Sarah Jane Davidson. Emily Francois. Casey J. Hathaway. Sarah Elaine Love. Joseph Jege Nihia. Madison Victoria O'Brien. Tasha Louise Reynolds. Kirsty Ann Roberts. Peter Allen Thompson. Georgia Kate Van Driel. Catherine Leslie Daphne Wright. And Wen Zhu. To the degree of Master of Psychology Clinical, Vanessa Bartholomeus. Nicholas Henry Kronowski. Ellen Louise Kelson. Siok Ping King. Victoria Faith Rivers. Vanessa Faith Schultz. And Molly Kate Kalankos Wright. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy with Master of Psychology, Organisational and Human Factors, for a thesis entitled Applying Depletion Theory and Personal Construct Psychology to Understand Cybersecurity Fatigue, the Development and Exploration of a Four-Component Model, Dr. Andrew John Reeves. And for a thesis entitled 24/7 Safety Climate, Developing a Brief 24-Item 7-Dimension Measure of Work Safety Climate for Monitoring and Remediating Safety Concerns, Dr. Denver Stephen Summers. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Psychology, Clinical, for a thesis entitled Exploring Systemic Injustice and Wellbeing Among Uyghurs in Australia, Dr. Mastura Alim. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Belonging to the World Online, Older Adults' Use of Computer-Mediated Communication for Social Wellbeing, Dr. Belinda Grace Fuss. for a thesis entitled Bullying in Early Adolescence, the Psychosocial, Emotional Wellbeing and Academic Outcomes of Victimization, Dr. Sarah Louise Halliday. For a thesis entitled Developing a Stronger Theory of Eyewitness Memory, the Selection, Verification and Application of Mathematical Models of Identification Decisions, Dr. Kim Michelle McCormick. For a thesis entitled Psychological Literacy in Undergraduate Psychology Learning and Teaching, Dr. Samantha Jane Newell. For a thesis entitled Effectiveness of Dialectical Behaviour Therapy Group Skills Training for Borderline Personality Disorder in Regional Community Mental Health, Dr. Brooke Elise Packham. And for a thesis entitled Promoting Lifestyle Change in the Preconception Period, Development of the Begin Better eHealth Intervention, Dr. Jody Michelle Scott. Deputy Chancellor, this concludes the graduates from the School of Psychology and for this ceremony.
Deputy Chancellor, every year the University presents university medals to acknowledge the most outstanding graduates in each faculty who have completed a University of Adelaide bachelor's degree with honours or a bachelor's degree of at least 4 years duration. The university medals are awarded to them for their consistent, outstanding performance across the whole of their undergraduate studies. I, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice Chancellor, External Engagement of the University of Adelaide, present to you a recipient of the 2022 University Medal from the Faculty of Health and Medical Sciences, Joe James Mandrell. Deputy Chancellor, University Doctoral Research Medals are awarded to graduates who have completed outstanding research at a doctoral level. This award is the premier award for doctoral candidates at the university. I, Dr. Jessica Gallagher, Deputy Vice Chancellor, External Engagement of the University of Adelaide, present to you the recipients of the 2022 University Doctoral Research Medals for research in the field of psychology, Sarah Louise Halliday. And Kate Louise Obst.
Thank you very much. I'm now very pleased to present to you Andrew John Reeves, who was presented this morning with the Doctor of Philosophy and Master of Psychology, Organisational and Human Factors. Andrew will now give the valedictory address on behalf of the cohort of graduates who were presented with their awards today. Can you please welcome Andrew? Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. It's an incredible honour to speak to you today. Before I begin, I wanted to say that when I started this degree, I had hair, which shows how long it has been. It's been a full 10 years this year. I only realised that when I was putting together this speech. I began my journey here at the university back in 2013. Like most, uni was just one of the many other commitments that I had to balance alongside work, relationships, other personal commitments. And when I started, like a lot of people graduating today, I didn't fully know what I wanted to do with my career. I didn't know what opportunities were out there and what apparent opportunities would end up being dead ends. All any of us could do was start down a path and trust that we could find our way through. I think of it now like navigating through a forest. We can look back and see how our path maybe wasn't the most direct or the most efficient, but at the time, all we could see was trees, and we pushed ahead in the hope of finding a way through. All of the graduates here today can be proud of themselves that in one way or another, you faced that uncertain future and you found your way through. A pivotal point for me was in 2017, when I entered the honours year of the Bachelor of Psychology, which some of you are graduating from today. In that year, I had the incredible opportunity to work with expert researchers in the field. At the start of my honours year, I met a researcher with the Defence Science and Technology Group, a connection that was only possible due to the strong links between the University of Adelaide and the Australian Defence Forces. Until that moment, I had planned to use my training in psychology, like a lot of you, to become a psychologist, to do therapy. And I vividly remember sitting in the room as she spoke about her work, which combined psychology and cybersecurity. I'd never put that together before. It was a light bulb moment. It was the first time I properly understood how my training in psychology could be applied to careers outside of mental health. It lit a fire in me that's still there today. This person became my honours supervisor, eventually my PhD supervisor, and she's here today. In this moment, not only do we reflect back on what we've achieved, but we also reflect on the incredible people that have gotten us here. Within the university, our mentors, professors, tutors, and fellow students have all added their piece and built us into the people we are today. Outside of the university, our families, our work colleagues, and our friends remind us of why we came here and why we work to make them proud. My parents, who are here today, always used to say to me when I was stressed, which was pretty often, take it one day at a time. That always calmed me down and kept me on track. Well, I calculated my PhD took 1,460 days, each day taken one at a time. Our time here at the university has gifted many of us some of our closest friends. As we prepare to leave this place, many of these people will follow us. For some, these people become our colleagues. For others, they become some of our closest friends. I'm sure my fellow students will agree with me that without these people, the experience at uni would have been far less enjoyable, probably far less productive, although probably a bit more sober. While today is about the celebration of our achievements, it's important for us to reflect on the journey to this point, our ups and downs, and what we've learned. It's easy for us, I think, to constantly compare ourselves to what is the next achievement, the next thing we need to do, the next job, the next degree. But it's equally important for us to take stock of how far we've come, of what we've achieved, and how proud our younger selves would be of us in this moment. In that spirit, I invite all of the graduates to now stand and join me to thank our family, our friends, our mentors, our university staff, and everyone else who has supported us throughout the journey that has led up to our graduation today. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew, for a fine speech. It now gives me great pleasure to congratulate all of the new graduates here today. Be proud of what you have worked to achieve and remember those who have supported you to reach this end. I wish you every success as you enter this next exciting stage of your life and your career. As graduates of the University of Adelaide, you are also its alumni and ambassadors. Over the years since the university was established, its alumni have made enormous contributions to the community, both here and throughout the world, and today you join this community of over 150,000 alumni located in more than 135 countries around the globe. We also have 21 global alumni networks, including 8 international networks, and we do hope that you'll remain an active part of the alumni network. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the mace bearer and the valedictorian, and all of those who assisted in today's ceremony. I ask all of the graduates to remain seated, and now I invite everyone else to stand, and once again, join me in congratulating the graduates on their achievements. Could everyone remain standing, please? We'd like the audience to remain standing, and could the graduates now please stand for the academic recession? So once the academic recession has left the hall, we ask guests to please remain at your seats until directed by to the exit by staff. And I now declare this congregation adjourned. Thank you very much.